So now we have arrived at a very important topic, and that's the notion of a column space. What's the column space? Well, first of all, let's start by asking the following question. Is the set S described by all vectors that can be the result of multiplying A times a vector X, is that a subspace? Well, go do the homework and come back. And it turns out that the answer is true. And how do you prove that? Well, we know that 0 is in this set because we can pick our x to be 0, and then A times 0 is 0. Okay, now if we pick two vectors in this set, then it is not hard to show that V plus S is in this set. How do you do that? Well, you pick two arbitrary vectors in this set, then you know that the first vector V is the result of A times X for some vector X, and you know that the other vector W is the result of A times Y for some vector Y. If you then look at V plus W, you see that that's A times X plus A times Y, because we knew that there was an X that had and a Y that had that property. But we know we can pull out the A, so we get A times X plus Y. And notice that therefore the vector V plus W is the result of multiplying A times some vector, namely the vector X plus Y. Similarly, if you start with a vector V in the set and a scalar alpha, we can once ask the question, is alpha times V in the set? But if you pick an arbitrary alpha and an arbitrary V, then we know that there is some x such that V is A times X, because otherwise V would not be in this set right here. And if you then look at alpha times V, that's alpha times A times X, but you can take that scalar and move it inside, and you get this right here. And what that means is that there is a vector, namely the vector alpha times X, that maps to the vector alpha times V. And therefore we conclude that this is a subspace. So, A times X equals B. This is the big question that we've been asking all along. Under what circumstances does the linear system described by AX equals B have a solution? Well, it has a solution if and only if B is in this space, this subspace. That particular subspace has a special name. It's called the column space of A, and it's the set of all vectors that can be achieved by multiplying A times some other vector X. Okay. It's denoted by this script C of A. Why do we call this the column space? Well, if you look at A times X, we can bust A up by columns. Now this is the moment that we've been training you for the entire course, to think about A in terms of columns. If you do A times X, then that's just A0 times the first component, A1 times the second component, etc. So you get this right here. Notice that that's a linear combination of the columns of A. So the column space is simply the set of all vectors that are linear combinations of the columns of A. And that's summarized right there. So here's a theorem. A times AX equals B has a solution if and only if B is in the column space of A. And the proof, as usual, you go in one direction. If AX is equal to B, then you know that B is an element in this set right here. But that is exactly the definition of the column space of A. If you go in the other direction and you say, assume that B is in the column space of A, then by definition, B is in this set right here. But this set right here says that there is a solution vector X that solves AX equals B. So in summary, the column space of A describes the subspace of all vectors for which AX equals B has a solution. Typically, it has an infinite number of elements. We're going to become very familiar with the column space of A as we move on.